गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, आई होप यू आर टेकिंग गुड केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ। वी हैड स्टार्टेड चैप्टर 5 क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस। नाउ बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द न्यू टॉपिक फॉर टुडे, लेट्स फर्स्ट रिकॉल व्हाट वी हैड स्टडीड सो फार। सो हियर आर द पॉइंट्स दैट वी नीड टू रिमेंबर। फर्स्ट वन, हाउ विल वी आइडेंटिफाई दैट द पर्टिकुलर इक्वेशन इज क्वाड्रेटिक और नॉट। First point was it should have one variable and the maximum power should be 2. Then we studied standard form ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Every quadratic equation must be converted into standard form where a, b and c are the coefficients and they are the real numbers. Then next point is every quadratic equation will have exactly 2 roots, and roots are actually the answers that we are going to get after factorization or by the formula. Then each root will satisfy the given quadratic equation. That means whatever answers you have, if you substitute that value back in the equation, you will get left hand side and right hand side to be equal. That is the meaning of this point. Then we studied nature of the roots. D, discriminant equals to b square minus 4ac. This a, b and c will be from here. So every quadratic equation we have to convert it in the standard form. Then we will pick up the coefficients a, b and c. Will substitute in the formula of discriminant. If the value of discriminant is greater than 0, that means the answer of that quadratic equation will be real and both the answers will be distinct, unequal. If the discriminant is equal to 0, that means root will be real and both the answers are going to be same, equal. If discriminant is less than 0, that means the roots are imaginary and we need not further solve the given quadratic equation in class 10th. Okay, let's move on to our next topic, that is solving quadratic equations by factorization. Only 3 steps we have to do. The most easiest factorization, you have done this factorization in class 9th. First of all, step 1, we have to convert all the quadratic equations in the standard form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Make sure your right hand side should be 0 only, no other number will work. Then point number 2, factorize by splitting middle term in the standard form. So once you convert the quadratic equation in the standard form, the next step you have to do is middle term factorization that you have already done in class 9th. So I don't think there will be a much problem. Then step 3, zero product rule. And this also we have done in class 9. If product of any two numbers is zero, that means either one of them is zero or both of them will be zero. Again, make sure zero product rule should contain zero on one side. 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2. No number will work, only zero should be there on one side. And on the other side, the product of two numbers or two expressions should be there. So let's start with some questions. Okay, this is question number 1 of your exercise 5C. So you can see the equation is already in the standard form, x square term, x term, constant term. So step 1 already cleared. Now step 2, middle term splitting. So that means the sum should be minus 10 and the product should be minus 24. I don't think I need to tell you what to do next. Let's see. X square the factors will be minus 12x and plus 2x minus 24. Once you write it down, must check it back with the sign specially. Minus 12 plus 2 will definitely give me minus 10. And the product minus 12 into plus 2 will be minus 24. So perfect. Now grouping x common from the first group. So here I am left with x and here I am left with minus 12. Now from the second group, I am taking plus common and 2 also as common. So here I have taken 2 common, so I am left with x. And here I have taken 2 common, so I am left with minus 12. If you have any doubt at any point, you can multiply back and check you are getting this or not. Let's see, x square, first term, minus 12x, second term, plus 2x, third term, minus 24, fourth term. And since the brackets are also same, so the factorization is done properly. X plus 2. Now step number 3, zero product rule. That means x minus 12 is 0 and x plus 2 is also 0. So here I am getting x equal to 12, x equal to minus 2. So these are the roots of this quadratic equation. And the nature of the roots are real and unequal. So if I say determine the nature of the root, do you still need to find discriminant? Or I can directly say because I have the answers also. So definitely it is going to come greater than 0. Because I have the actual value of the roots. If I could have not solved this, then I can check the nature of the root from this. So next question, I have taken question 5 of your textbook. This is the question, and surely this is not in the standard form right now. So I want you to pause the video for a while and convert it in the standard form and split middle term. First of all, x square term. Then I need this term because this is having power 1. So this side I am shifting, so this will become 9 by 2x and this side will remain same, 5 equals to 0. Now it's better to remove the denominator because splitting of minus 9 by 2 will be a difficult task. So I am taking LCM. Here it will be 2x square minus 9x plus 5 into 2, 10 equal to 0. 2x square minus 9x plus 10, and when 2 will be multiplied with the 0, it will give me 0. Now I have an equation without the denominator and the equation is now in the standard form. Now split middle term and your final answers. Your answers will be x equal to 5 by 2 and x equal to 2. So our next question is 2x minus 3 whole square equals to 49. Again, this is not in the standard form. We will open a minus b whole square identity. 4x square minus 12x plus 9 equal to 49. Now since we need only 0 on right hand side, so we will shift this here according to the standard form. Plus 9 minus 49. Now this can be simplified further. Minus, this will become. Now this is up to you if you want to split middle term here or you want to simplify it further, because this is also a standard form and if I take 4 common, this will be 3x minus 10 equal to 0. This 4 will be divided here, so 0 by 4 will be 0. So it's your wish, you can split middle term at this step also. Your answer will remain same. This is only for further simplification, nothing else, to make the calculations easy. Now middle term splitting is your task. Solve it and your final answers are x equal to 5 and x equal to minus 2. Next question is question number 13. Observe the question. There are many ways of solving a particular question. First way is you can open this identity a square a plus b whole square, and then you multiply this. This will be minus 4x and minus 12 and minus 5, and then simplifying all to convert into standard form perfectly well. Let's be a little smart now. As we can see, this bracket, both are same. So let us take this x plus 3 to be some another variable, say m. Now the question converts to m square minus 4m minus 5. Now directly we can split middle term. Let's quickly find out the factors. When you will solve and split the middle term, you will get m plus 1 and m minus 5 as the factors. I'm not solving by splitting middle term because in class 9 you have completely done this topic. So I'm leaving it on you. Now, zero product rule. M plus 1 is 0 or m minus 5 is also 0. So here m equals to minus 1, m is equals to 5. So the values of m are minus 1 and 5. But the question was to solve this quadratic equation. That means to solve for the value of x, not m. So in the end, we will substitute the value of m, that is x plus 3 equals to minus 1. Here also we will substitute the value x plus 3 equals to 5. Now we will get actual values x equal to minus 1, and this we will shift minus 3. So one value we have got minus 4, and the other value will be 5 minus 3, which is equals to 2. So the two values are minus 4 and 2. Question number 21, first part. Now let's try a different category of questions. Find the quadratic equation whose solution set is 3, 5. By the word solution set, what they mean? Solution set means the roots of a particular quadratic equation. And since they both are the roots, that means somewhere the value of the variable answers will be this. So if I shift 3 on the other side, it will become x minus 3 equal to 0. And if I shift this on the other side, x minus 5 equals to 0. So this is actually the reverse way. What we do generally, if I have say x minus a and x minus b equals to 0. So by zero product rule we separate them. So in this case they are already separated. Either this is 0 or this is 0. So from this step we have to jump to the previous step now. That is x minus 3 into x minus 5. Is this step clear? Why we have done this? Now, when we multiply the two binomials, this is x square, then x with this minus 5x, देन दिस विद दिस माइनस 3x, द जनरल मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ टू बाइनोमियल्स. दीज टू आर द लाइक टर्म्स, सो वी कैन सिंप्लीफाई दिस. माइनस 8x प्लस 15. सो वी हैव गॉट अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन हूज सॉल्यूशन सेट वर 3,5. सॉल्यूशन सेट मीन्स दीज आर द आंसर्स, एंड वेन दीज आर द आंसर्स दैट मीन्स दे आर द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स. सो वी हैड शिफ्टेड दिस ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड दिस ऑल्सो. सो फ्रॉम प्लस साइन चेंजेस एंड फ्रॉम प्लस हेयर ऑल्सो साइन चेंजेस. नाउ फॉर नेक्स्ट स्टेप, एज वी अप्लाई जीरो प्रोडक्ट रूल, वी आर अप्लाइंग जीरो प्रोडक्ट रूल फ्रॉम सेकेंड स्टेप टू फर्स्ट स्टेप. वी हैव दिस इक्वल टू जीरो एंड दिस इक्वल टू जीरो, दैट मीन्स द प्रोडक्ट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू बी जीरो, एंड वी हैव मल्टीप्लाइड एंड दिस इज आर रिक्वायर्ड क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 23, फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इफ ए प्लस वन इज जीरो. So I'm stopping here because I saw some information here. A plus 1 equals to 0. That means A equals to minus 1 because 1 will be shifted here. And this. So we need to find the value of x. Now we know the value of A. We will substitute the value of A here. This will become x square minus 1 x minus 6 equal to 0. At the place of A, I have substituted this value. X square minus x minus 6 equal to 0. Now, this is basic middle term splitting. So, when you will solve this, you will get two values of x, 3 and minus 2. Kindly solve all the questions whose steps I am leaving for you. Do not skip these questions. All the questions which I have done in my all videos, kindly solve them in the notebook and then start the assignment questions. Next question, number 29. If x equal to minus 3 and x equal to 2 by 3 are solutions of quadratic equation this. Find the values of m and n. Now in the previous class, we had studied that if we have been given x is equal to something is the solution or root or answer of a quadratic equation, then that means this particular value will definitely satisfy this equation. And in this question, we have been given two roots. Two solutions are directly given. So we will substitute them. Let's see what happens. Mx square plus 7x plus n equal to 0. One side we will substitute the value of x equal to minus 3. Minus 3 square plus 7 minus 3 plus n equal to 0. This will be 9m. This will become minus 21. Plus n equal to 0. So 9m plus n, this 21 will be shifted on right hand side. Now when the other root we will substitute, m 2 by 3 whole square plus 7 2 by 3 plus n equals to 0. This will become 4 by 9m, 14 by 3 plus n equals to 0. For easy calculations, I am going to take LCM. LCM of 9, 3 and 1 will be 9. 4m plus 42 plus 9n. Equal to 0. Now this will be multiplied here. 4m plus 42 plus 9n equals to 0. When 9 will be multiplied here, this will become automatically 0. Now we have two equations, equation number 1, equation number 2. Let us simplify this furthermore. 4m plus 9n equals to minus 42, equation number 2. So using equation 1 and 2, can we apply elimination or substitution or cross multiplication? So 9m plus n equals to 21. 4m plus 9n equals to minus 42. Applying the method of elimination, I will get m to be 3 and n to be minus 6. I want the solution of elimination method also. So in your answers, apply elimination and solve them. Next question is question 31, last question for today. As you can see, the question looks very difficult, but the question is actually very easy. It is just the way of its presentation. So we will first code down the given informations properly. Given that 2 is a root of the equation this. So till here I am noting down the information first. There is a quadratic equation whose root is 2. That means when I will substitute 2 at the places of x. Let us first do that. Wherever I can see x, I will substitute the value of its root. That is the answer. So this will be 12 minus, if I multiply this, this will be minus 2p and minus p. 12, these are the like terms, minus 3p equals to 0. So 12 equals to 3p, and you can say the value of p is then 12 by 3 equal to 4. So one value we have got, the value of p, by just solving it this way. Now let us read the question further. And that the equation this has equal roots. That means now we have another equation, px square minus qx plus 9 equal to 0. It has equal roots. The value of root is not given to us now, but the condition given is it has equal root. That is the nature. Do you remember? What does it mean? Equal roots? The roots are equal only when the discriminant is equal to 0. So let's proceed. That means the discriminant here. So first, to find the discriminant, we need to find d equals to b square minus 4ac. So where are a, b and c? Is this in the standard form? Yes, it is. Power 2, power 1, constant. Yes. So the value of a is this, b is this, and this is c. So discriminant is 0 because of this given condition, equal roots. B square, that means square of minus q, minus 4 into a, p into c, 9. And in first part, we have already solved for the value of p. So in the place of p, we will substitute its value. And minus q square will become q square only. So q square, and this whole, we will shift on this side. So I will get some plus value. 4 into 4 into 9. So 16 into 9 with under root as I remove this square. So I will get 4 into 3 as the value of q. So final value of q is 12. In the end, I will definitely highlight the final answers for better evaluation. So that's it for today. I want you to solve all the questions which I have solved in the video and the questions which I am giving you now. So you have to attempt only those questions in the book which I have marked. This is your assignment, exercise 5C. Attempt only the questions which I have marked. The questions which I have already done, those also you have to solve yourself while watching the video. Do not just watch the video, solve it with me. And some remaining questions of the same exercise. Answers also you can match from here, exercise 5C. Children, the more you will solve yourself, the more you will practice yourself, the more you will get. So keep practicing. Ask doubts with your friends, with me, whenever possible. I will definitely answer all your queries. Thank you.